Hi, folks. Welcome back. Great to see you here, and it's great that we're able to get in and get on with some machining. So we've got our geometry that we've already created. Now we're going to apply some machining operations to that. So we'll kick off by creating the piece. We'll select the geometry, choose our routing operations, and then look at how to do a CAD simulation. First thing we need to do is turn this geometry, which is just a bunch of lines, and make it into something on a piece of material. So we need some material to machine. You can't just machine random geometry out in the middle of nowhere. So first off, let's select everything. So click, hold, drag, select everything. Click on the piece icon here. So piece, or you can go Control-P. And to add that geometry to the piece, you click on the green plus sign here. And there's all your geometry contained in a piece of material. We're going to set that to 12 millimeters because that's how thick we want our finished job. Once you've set that up, click OK, and you're ready to start some machining operations. So over on the far left here, you've got your first toolbar. If you click on the machining operations icon in there and go straight to the third one down, the yellow worm, milling. So click on the milling icon there, and that should bring up this whole new toolbar over on the right-hand side here. So first things first, let's be careful about the geometry that we're going to machine. So let's deselect by unticking these boxes. See where I'm ticking over here, the things that I don't want. Okay, so remove all the ticks that I don't want. Do I want to do those two holes? No, so they must be hidden down in here. Just make sure we've unticked all of those. All right, so you can see I've just got this external toolpath, this external piece of geometry. That's the one I want to work with. I've said before, we go left to right across the screen, top to bottom, down the screen. So we're starting at the top of the screen, selecting the geometry. Let's now select our tool radius correction. So correction is where you place the tool in relation to the geometry. So in this case, we're going for external. Next thing down, select the lead in, lead out point. This is the point where the routing is going to actually start. So we want to start it on one of the straight sides over there. So just click near your geometry and it'll pop your start point over there with that little black icon. Next, we'll choose the tool that we want. So green dots indicate a tool that's actually loaded in the machine. No green dot, it's a tool that's been set up but is no longer actually mounted in the machine. So select the tool that you want. Set the depth. We're going to use the through machining function so that we machine through the whole thickness of the panel by 0.2 of a millimeter. So we've got 0.2 here through. If you unclick that, it's just going to be 0.2 mil into the top of your piece. But we want to go all the way through. We will pretty much use the defaults that we've saved in here. So we want a 3D line. We'll set the angle down low to about 20 degrees. We'll go 100% of the radius of the tool for that. We'll do our lead out the same as the lead in, so you can close those up now. Vertical passes, we're doing two vertical passes. We'll do one pass almost all the way through and do the final end pass at 1 millimeter. Let's try bi-directional just for fun. And then the rest of it we can probably leave where it is. So horizontal passes, we want a single horizontal pass, so no onion skinning. Speed data as per the tool setup. Safety data as per the tool setup. Machining data, there's nothing to change in there. We've got a 5 mil overlap, so an internal and a final, sorry, initial and final extension of 5 mil, just to overlap the cutter a little bit at the beginning and the end. Once you're happy, hit calculate and it'll give you a little graphic simulation, or not really a simulation, just a graphic idea of what's going on. So you can see these two green lines, that's the tip of the center of the tool for the lead in and lead out, showing the depth of the tool and the position of what's going on. This orangey colored line in here, that's the center of the tip of the tool. Okay, so it always shows the center of the tip of your tool for the actual machining operation. You can see it's outside of the geometry by the radius of the tool itself, and you can see the length of the lead in and lead out here as per the settings that we set there. If you're happy with that, hit OK, and there you have it, your first machining operation done. If you want to have a quick squeeze, a quick look at what's going on, click on this little play icon up here. It'll do a CAD simulation for you. When you're ready, maybe slow this down a little bit. It will remove your waste. You can increase the quality. If you click on play here, it will then do a simulation. So first cut at first of our vertical passes, and there's the bi-directional for our second pass. And you can see the tool path, the lead in and the lead out in the tool path there. If you think that's all good and you're all happy with that, then save that there and you can continue on and do some more machining. So we're going to use standard milling for this section of geometry here, except we'll go internal rather than external for our tool correction. And then we'll do some of the just close that for a second. In this, for this text down here, we'll try and use the 3-axis 3D engraving, which does a lovely finish on text. And we'll pocket this hole out as we don't have a drill that's 20 mil in diameter. All right. So I'll see you back soon and we'll go through those operations as well. Thanks.